Hi, I'm Janice Seitz with Ivy's Management Communications Area Group, and today we're talking to Raf Harfouch about digital media and business today. So Raf, could you tell me how you got interested in digital media?
I mean, my background with digital media has just started from a love of browsing online and reading a lot of websites and just being fascinated by the creativity and the ingenuity that people were showing online. So, you know, when blogs first started, I was so fascinated in reading everybody's journals and thoughts, and I thought it was such a great way for people to share. And that was just the beginning. I mean, now it's expanded, and it's I love how it's redefining our connections with each other, how it's giving us more opportunities, more risks as well. But I think I've just always been very curious, and the internet is the perfect vortex for people that are curious. So it was a natural fit for my, you know, my natural curiosity about a wide variety of topics. And then digital just happened to be the string that connected them all.
Great. And what kind of impact has digital media had on the way we do business today?
Well, I mean, it's really been a great equalizer. Traditionally, business strategy has been one where it's the company that determines the strategy, it's the company that determines what's going to be said, how it's going to be said, when it's going to be said, and the consumer is just this receiver of information. They receive it very passively. And now consumers have become active participants in this discussion, and in some cases, they have the ability to have a dramatic impact on the brand. So it's the consumers that are controlling what's being said, and it's the company that now needs to be a bit more cognizant of the fact that they don't own that conversation. And the second thing is that just the rise of applications and new startups and new businesses, it has created an area of and a period of innovation and also mass disruption. If you could have run your company the exact same way for the last 10 years with no problem, and suddenly two kids in a garage can start a web app that completely changes the market and redefines your entire industry. So I think it's made things much more exciting. But it's also a bit perilous. It's also a bit scary because I think a lot of leaders don't really understand how to navigate in this fluid space and how to be agile. So,
excellent. And so when did you have this aha moment that digital media was something that you would pursue as a career?
I didn't actually know that you could pursue digital media as a career. I just thought if I could find a way to get people to pay me for being online, that would be the best case scenario. But I think the big moment for me was when I was researching Wikonomics with Don Tapscott, who's a great mentor of mine, who I actually met for the first time in this room here at Ivy. He was really the one who showed me that digital was so much more than just marketing. Digital was the opportunities for people who would have never had the chance otherwise to start businesses, for people who would have never been heard to have a platform where their thoughts can be heard, and for people all over the world who might be separated by geography and by massive distances and different cultural backgrounds can online have this opportunity to mobilize and create create massive change for good and bad. Again, I mean, the shady side, you've got these online hacker collectives. The more positive side, you've got protesters, you know, protesting for democracy and working on behalf of those who would like to get democracy. And so that really opened my eyes, and I thought this is something that is going to fundamentally rewire the DNA of almost every single industry that I know. And that was important enough for me to really try to understand where the opportunity for me as a strategist could come into play and how I could provide values in understanding those trends.
Excellent. And if you had to give advice to our HBA students or even our MBA students going forward with their careers, what could you tell them about how they could possibly get into this space?
The funny thing is they don't have to get into this space. It's like, guess what? We're in this space. So they just have to decide whether or not they want to engage because the barriers of entry are so low. The easiest thing is to be open to it. Just make up, you know, sign up for a bunch of different services, try them, see what works, see what you like. Every single community online is like its own little tribe. And the best feeling is when you find a tribe that really represents you and people like you and people who have the same values as you. And I have formed, you know, tribes with people online that I've never met who I have a closer relationship to sometimes than people that I've known in the real world. So I would say you just have to be experimenting, and I want to debunk the idea of like expertise, because you're only as good as the last platform you're on. And so people should not be intimidated. Everything in digital changes so fast that the rules change every 6 months anyway. So just start doing it, start reading about it, start talking to people about it, and then find out. The trick is this. The trick is to find the area where your passion intersects with digital. It's not just about digital. Forget it. Digital is just going to be this like the wiring that you can't see. It's going to be like the air. If you like fashion or philanthropy or sports or automotive industry or finance or healthcare or pharmaceuticals, find the thing that you're really into and find how technology is changing that space, and that was the best portal to enter.
Excellent. Right. And going forward, our students are looking for jobs. What are some of the best ways to navigate the whole issue of networking in social media or digital media?
I mean, the thing with networking is that I sort of sometimes have a negative reaction to it because it almost implies a very calculated effort to connect with somebody to benefit yourself. And that's why, by comparison, I talk about online tribes, because with online tribes or with online communities, you form relationships with people based on shared values, on mutual interests, on shared passions, and you build genuine relationships that, in my experience, have always yielded far more lucrative offers of clients and projects and opportunities than going to a mixer and introducing myself and being very, very, very pushy. So I think the opportunities now are incredible because, thanks to technology, the walls between me and somebody in another country that's doing something really cool are non-existent. I mean, I have had more coffee Skype dates and coffee dinner dates with people all around the world that I've never met before, just to say, "I'm really interested in your work. I just wanted to meet you." And that is so easy. It's so, I mean, Twitter, you can tweet almost anybody. And you, so the access, the accessibility factor is gone, and you don't need to be all stressed out anymore. And I really feel that building like a genuine connection with another human being in the long term has always provided far more value than trying to get a job. So yeah.
Well, thank you so much, Raf, for coming to Ivy and speaking with us today.
Thank you so much for having me.
Thank you.